In this lecture, we're going to discuss about the United Nations, how it came into the picture and how it was formed. So this is basically the history of United Nations organization. Okay, we have done this a lot of times. The term United Nations was first used by Franklin D. Roosevelt in 1st January 1942 during the Second World War, when the representatives of 26 nations pledged against the Axis powers. Axis powers then was Germany, Italy and Japan. So post the First World War, the League of Nations was established to maintain peace and security, but obviously it majorly fails, hence the Second World War takes place. So the charter was signed by the representatives of the 50 countries in the end. So charter was first ratified by China, France, the Soviet Union, the United Kingdom and United States, which was then the Allied powers, and by the other majority signatories. Hence, they become the permanent members of the United Nations organization. So the very first declaration which ever took place in the creation of United Nations was the declaration of the St. James Palace on 12th June 1941. So during the World War II, all the Allied powers along with the other nations pledged to stand together against the Axis powers. So Great Britain, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Africa and all the exiled governments of Belgium, Czechoslovakia, Greece, Luxembourg and the Netherlands, Norway, Poland, France met at St. James Palace and signed the declaration in London to fight as a pact, fight together against the Axis powers. Hence, this is also called as London Declaration. So the only agenda of this declaration was the willing cooperation of the free people in the world. Also, after 10 days of this declaration, Hitler launched attack on Russia. On 14th August 1941, the Atlantic Charter came into the picture. So two months post the London Declaration was the next step towards creating World Organization. Hence, a meeting between President Roosevelt and Prime Minister Churchill took place on the coast of Newfoundland. So this was not a treaty between the two powers, or it was just an affirmation that of certain common principles in the national policies of the respective countries on which they based for their future, for the better future. So they pledged to abandon the force and war and establish a wider and a permanent system to curb the chaos going on all around the world. On 1st January 1942, Declaration of the United Nations took place. So, as we all know, during the Second World War, the Japanese attack on the Pearl Harbor on 7th December 1941. So, United States of America hence enters into the dimension of the World War II. Then the Allied powers were staggered by Japan's success because it was coming with a huge force. So in 1945, in Washington, D.C., 26 states signed the declaration. Their main principles were to promote respect for human rights on an international basis. And also the term United Nations was used for the first time by Roosevelt to express unity against the Axis powers. On 30th October 1943 took place the Moscow Declaration, which was mainly formed to replace the League of Nations, replace it with something better. So by 1943, the Allied nations were committed to the victory, and they attempted to create a world where men in all land may live out their lives in freedom from fear and want, was their agenda, which was highlighted in the declaration. So US, UK, Russia, China came together to establish a sovereign equality to all peace-loving states and the general security, and also fight against the Axis powers. So in 1944 to 1945 took place the Dumbarton, Oaks and Yalta conference. So in this conference, this was the first important step which was taken towards the creation of the international organization, which led to international peace and security. In this declaration, the principles of the world organizations were to be laid down, but it is a long step because it was a very lengthy process, because they had to define the principles, find the purpose, create a preamble, then set up a body, take a blueprint, then forward it, circulate it amongst the nations, and then get their permission and then get them sign the declaration and bring everyone together. So this was a huge process, and this particular conference was a first step towards the real creation of the international organization. So representatives of China, Britain, USSR and United States met for a conference in Washington, D.C. So the discussion was completed on 7th October 1944, and a proposal for the structure of the new organization was submitted by the four powers to all the United Nations government. Then on February 11th, 1945 at Yalta, okay, while discussing this on the Dumbarton Oaks conference, they just missed out on one thing, that was the voting procedure, which was covered later on February 11, 1945 at Yalta, where voting procedure was discussed, and also all the nations were summoned for the San Francisco conference. So on 5th March 1945, San Francisco conference took place, where the charter of the UN was signed on 26th June 1945, which came into force on 24th October 1945. Like I've been saying this a lot of times, I think, important date. Then Statute of ICJ was also formed, which was a very integral part of UN charter. Next important part of the UN Charter, United Nations, was the preamble. So in the preamble goes like this: we the people of UN decide to save the succeeding generation from wars and all the chaotic scenario around, and to reaffirm faith in human rights, dignity and equality of rights for men and women was given utmost importance to justice and respect for the obligation which is created by the UN itself, because it has to, people have to obligate the UN for it to function in a proper way. And then social progress and better standard of living was also promoted and stated in the preamble. And their main goal was to reach international peace and security and acceptance of all the principles that has been laid down in the charter, and also economic and social advancement of the countries were paid attention to. Principles form a very important role. So the principles of UN was sovereign equality. That means each and every nation has given, will be treated equally in the eyes of the law, and no partial discrimination or partiality would be done to the member states. Honoring obligation, they have to honor the obligation created by UN. There will be peaceful settlement of disputes. People might have differences, states, but they'll come together, sit and have a peaceful settlement of the dispute. No usage of force. They will not use force, because it was just leading to further deterioration of the economic and the international scenario. And each and every state member will be obligated to assist UNO whenever it is required. Then there were principles of non-members, which is mentioned in Article 2 of the Charter, which basically talks about the fact that even if the states are not members of UN, they should follow the principles of this particular organization to maintain peace and harmony internationally. And non-interference in domestic affairs is mentioned in Article 2.7 of the Charter, which is that states will, in this particular organization, will not interfere in the domestic affairs of the state. I'll be quickly going through the important articles now. Article 3 deals with the original members of the UN organization, which have participated in the conferences at San Francisco and also signed the present charter and ratified it. Next is Article 4, which deals with the subsequent members, which is basically admission of a new member, which will take place with a decision of General Assembly after the recommendation of the Security Council. Article 5 deals with the suspension of the members. So if any preventive enforcement action has been taken by the Security Council, the particular state can be suspended from the exercise of the rights and privilege of the membership by the General Assembly. Next is Article 6, which deals with expulsion of the member. So if any of the state has been persistently violating the principles contained in the charter, they may be expelled from the organization. Article 108 deals with the ordinary procedure. Ordinary procedure basically is an amendment procedure where a vote of the 2/3 of the member of the General Assembly is required. Along with the 2/3 of the members of the United Nations and also the permanent members of the Security Council. That deals with the amendment in the charter. Next is Article 109, which deals with the extraordinary procedure. So this was on for the purpose of reviewing the present charter, where a two-third vote of the members of the General Assembly, also the vote of any 9 members of the Security Council, was required to ratify it, and each member of the UN shall have 1 vote in the particular conference. Next important thing is amendments have been made in charter in ordinary procedure. It was in 1963, 1965, 1971. Now I'll come down to questions. So the Charter of UN was signed on 26th June 1945, 2nd is 24th October 1945, 3rd is 5th March 1945, 4th is 11th February 1945. Answer is 1, 26th June 1945. The second question is Article 6 of the UN Charter. What does it talk about? Number 1, original members. Number 2, admission of new members. Number 3, suspension of the members. Number 4, expulsion of the members. And answer is number 4, expulsion of the members.